Getty, and see Vladimir Putin threaten the West with the power of his new Sarmat missile. The test launch, shown on an Easter message video from the Russian Defense Ministry, came as Vladimir Putin ordered further cuts to Britain's diplomatic ranks in Moscow. Meanwhile, police in Salisbury are closing in on the gang behind the Nervagent poisoning of double agent Sergei Skripal and his daughter Yulia, which has led to tit-for-tat expulsions. In the video, the Satan II missile emerges from an underground silo, pauses as if hovering above the ground, and then speeds away in a cloud of white smoke. The launch was at the snow-covered Polisetsk spaceport in the northern Archangel province of Russia, close to the Arctic Circle. The new intercontinental ballistic missile was hailed by the Russian president as being able to fly over the North or South Poles and strike any target in the world. No defense systems will be able to withstand it, Putin said during his State of the Nation speech earlier this month. As relations between Moscow and the West hit a new low not seen since the Cold War, the Russian Foreign Ministry yesterday gave Britain 30 days to reduce the number of diplomats in Moscow to the same number that Russia has in London. NC Putin said the Sarmat missile could hit anywhere. No one has listened to us. You listen to us now. Vladimir Putin. The UK expelled 23 Russian diplomats in the wake of the Salisbury attack. So far, more than 150 Russian diplomats, some of whom are suspected spies, have been ordered to return home by countries including the US, Germany, France, and Canada. Russian Foreign Minister Sergei Lavrov said Moscow would retaliate by expelling the same number of diplomats that each country had ejected. The ministry said it had summoned the British ambassador yesterday following the provocative and unsubstantiated actions by Britain, which instigated the expulsion of Russian diplomats from various nations for no reason. The number of British diplomats that will have to leave Russia was not immediately clear. Getty. Putin's words raised the stakes in the standoff after Sergei Skripal's poisoning. A Foreign Office spokeswoman said, "It's regrettable, but in light of Russia's previous behavior, we anticipated a response. However, this doesn't change the facts of the matter. The attempted assassination of two people on British soil, for which there is no alternative conclusion other than that the Russian state was culpable. Russia is in flagrant breach of international law and the Chemical Weapons Convention, and actions by countries around the world have demonstrated the depth of international concern." Mr. Lavrov spoke of harsh pressure from the United States and Britain under the pretext of the so-called Skripal case. He called for consular access to Yulia Skripal, a Russian citizen, who has recovered sufficiently to be able to help police investigating the attack. Russia, he said, was also seeking a meeting with leaders of the Organization for the Prohibition of Chemical Weapons to establish the truth. Russia and the West are also at loggerheads over interference in the 2016 U.S. presidential election, cyber attacks, Ukraine, and the war in Syria. In his speech, Putin boasted, "No one has listened to us. You listen to us now." He revealed other weapons his country apparently has in the pipeline, such as an underwater drone armed with a nuclear warhead powerful enough to sweep away coastal defenses and destroy aircraft carriers, and a nuclear-powered cruise missile that's invulnerable to any existing or prospective air and missile defense systems. The White House responded by saying Putin had merely confirmed what the U.S. already knows, that Russia has been developing destabilizing weapons systems for over a decade in direct violations of its treaty obligations. Expected to go operational in 2021, Satan II is capable of wiping out parts of the planet the size of France or Texas, according to Russian officials. If true, it could wipe out an area the size of England and Wales twice over.